These technologies are safe. Certainly when we see them in laboratory conditions or even in clinical situations, we know that the safety and the efficacy, and perhaps the effectiveness, are there as well. But once we let the proverbial cat out of the bag, well, at that point, now we let loose science and technology in the broader public sphere. And this then gets us into the actually derivative social issues. So what we see here are the issues of perhaps loss of autonomy. Is my thought, my emotion being controlled? Who should get these things? Only those individuals who have disorders? But we're just seeing that these techniques and technologies aren't just used to treat disorders, they're also being used to improve certain aspects of capability. So then who will be enabled? Who will be enhanced? What are the limits of that enhancement? Who will decide? And of course, ultimately, who will get these things in societies? Those who only need them? Those who can afford them? Those societies that have the capability to develop and utilize these various techniques? And what about those that can't? And or will these scientific and technological capabilities then be utilized to render power, as happens so often? The individuals, the groups, the politics, and the societies that have the most sophisticated tools and perhaps weapons win. And this then gets us into the entire area of whether or not neuroscience and technology can and will be weaponized. And clearly we're seeing that not only on the horizon, but in the realities of today.